Hello guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. This video is in continuation with our transformation and action series, where I have been telling you all the major transformations and actions in detail with hands-on demo. If you have not seen my previous tutorials on Spark transformations, please do watch them. I'll link them in I button and description below. This video will be completely on actions, as we have covered almost all major transformations in our last videos. Today we are going to see some important actions which will be useful for you in solving some of the use cases given to you by interviewer in a Spark interview. So we are going to start with very important action, that is aggregate. If you see the definition or syntax of aggregate action in some of the YouTube videos or some of the blogs, you will see this is the syntax of aggregate. When we have first look on the syntax, it seems a bit complicated. Generally we see we have to pass some zero value, some sequence operations, some combiner operation. Even if you go through different blogs, you will see they have explained it like we have to pass u, t and it will return u from u and t. This is not easily understandable for a beginner. So that is why I'll try to explain you the aggregate action in the easiest way I can explain. Let's consider we have an RDD and we have few elements in this. Let's consider we have 12 elements in this. And we partition this into four partitions. Considering an ideal case, these 12 values will go into four partitions as three values in each partition. Something like this. So as all the elements of our RDD are distributed into four partitions, whatever operation we perform on this RDD will be done in form of partitions on different worker nodes. This will be processed on, say, worker node A, worker node B, worker node C and worker node D. And all this will be handled by our driver program. Now suppose you have such a requirement that you have to perform some action on the values in each partition separately. Let's suppose a basic requirement. We want a sum of values in first partition, second partition, third partition and fourth partition. Sum of values of first partition will be 6, then 15, 24, 33. Sum of these three values. And now we want the aggregated result from each partition to be sent to our driver program so that we can get a final sum here. That is 78. So in such scenarios, where you have to perform operations on the values on each partition and you need some aggregated value as your result, in such cases, we have to use aggregate action. To make it more clear, let's not consider just the sum. Suppose we want a result, something like we want to add the maximum values in each partition, just the maximum values. Then what we have to do? We need two functions here. First function that should see what is the maximum values in each partition. Same function should check what is the maximum values in second partition, third, fourth and so on. Suppose our first function will give us this only because these are the maximum values. Now we need second function which should combine all the results from each partition. So these are the maximum values and we have to combine, suppose we have to get a sum. So the combined result of the sum, that is 30, should be given to our driver program. In such use cases, just make sure you have to use aggregate function. So I believe now this syntax will be more clear to you. The aggregate function takes a zero value. I'll come to this zero value. Now our first function that was used to operate a sequence on each partition, that was our sequence function. And the second function that was used to combine all the results, that was the combiner function. So these two functions will be taken as the arguments and one zero value. Now let's see what is this zero value. So these were our partitions. While aggregating and combining, if you want to give some initial value, that should be taken as a base while aggregating and combining. That you can give as a zero value. Let's suppose you have to perform this action two times, all the sequential sum and the combined sum. And on the second time, you want your first sum as your base and you want a cumulative sum of previous operation also. Suppose in the first time we have got the result as 100 and now you want to do this operation again and you want to add the result onto the previous output. In such cases, we can define what is the initial value that we have to take before we are going to aggregate and combine. So that is nothing but zero value. If you are doing this aggregate action first time, the zero value for add operation will be zero. Why it is zero? because if you add 0 to any number, it would be unchanged. Also keep in mind, 0 value for multiplication will be 1, not 0. Because multiplication with 1 won't change anything. So 0 value is basically the base on which you want to do the aggregate and combine option. So now let's see this with an example. Suppose I have a list, I have converted this into an RDD and I have 12 values in it. And we have distributed this RDD into 4 partitions. So ideally, these values will go to first partition, 1, 2, 3 will go to second, 5, 10 and 15 will go to third partition and 2, 4, 6 will go to fourth partition. Now let's do a hands-on on both the example, first for the addition and second for the maximum values addition, whatever we discussed just now. Now as I told you, the syntax would be rdd.aggregate 0 value. We are doing an add operation, so 0 value will be 0. Now we have to give two functions as an argument. First will be the sequence, second will be the combiner. Now as per our scenario, what this sequence function has to do, it has to add all the values in each partition. So simply we can provide add everything. Now again, what this combiner has to do, it has to add whatever sum we have got from each partition. So again, the same thing we can give. It is already an action, so it will right away give us the output. Let's see what we are getting. You can see we are getting sum of each and every element from all four partitions. As of this example, it's just giving us the sum, but on the back end, it is operating the way I explained. Now let's see the second use case also. If we have to add only the maximum values from each partition, in this case, our combiner operation will be as it is, because anyways, the maximum values from each partition also, we have to sum all of them, but we have to make some change in our sequence operation, because we don't want the sum of all values, we just want the maximum of each partition. So here what we can do, we can use a math function and take a max from that, and we don't need a sum, we have to just find the max value from all the values from each partition. Just notice, it will not consider the entire list in this operation. Because we are doing an aggregate, it will just consider the values in each partition. So let's see. If you can see, we are getting 54, 30, max of first partition 30, plus 3, plus 15, plus 6. That comes to 54. So just to recollect, when you are given the use case where you have to perform operations on values splitted partition wise and you have to do some aggregate, sum or max or some other operation, you should use aggregate action. So I believe aggregate action was clear to you. Now let's move to take. As the name suggests, with help of this action, you can take a sample of data from existing number of elements in an RDD. Suppose if I execute rdd.take5, it will give me 5 values from this list. You can see 5 values we are getting. So this is just to take the sample of data. This was about take. Now let's check reduce. You might have already seen how reduce works. It takes all elements and operates the given function on all elements. Let's consider this code. We have an RDD with 4 elements and we have given x.reduce. Consider each element as A and B and sum up all of them. So here what will happen? It will take 1 as A, 2 as B and sum them up. So 2 plus 1 will be 3. Now again it will take that element plus the next element and do the same operation. So finally we will get the sum of this RDD elements. We are getting 10. This was about reduce. Now let's see collect. Collect is just to display all the RDD elements. As you can see, if we just convert an array to an RDD and we execute it, Spark gives us the output that we have parallelized this array, but we don't get any output. So for converting this into an RDD and see the output, we can mention x.collect. Now if we execute it, we will get the output. So this was the collect action. Now this max, sum, all the actions are very simple as their name suggests. I'll quickly show the demo. So from this RDD, x.max will directly print the maximum value of this RDD. As you can see, we are getting 4 as the result. Same way, the sum will work. You can see we are getting the sum. Mean and standard deviation are used for some of the statistical counts if we have such kind of scenario. Now let's directly come to count by key. Suppose we have an RDD with key value pairs. As you can see, I have 4 key value pairs with key as the initial letter and value as a person's name. Now in such cases, if we have to count the number of values corresponding to each key, we can do this with one simple count by key action. So x dot count by key, and that's it. If I run this, you can see how easily Spark infers the keys and the values, and it is giving all the counts against each key in form of a map. Also, please note, this was also one of the interview question, that what is the output format of count by key action? That is, in which format the count by key action will give us the output. The answer for this is it returns a map. So guys, with this I have covered few of the important actions. There are many more in the list that I'll keep covering in my upcoming videos. Also, if you have doubt in any of the transformation and action and you are not able to understand it, please let me know in the comment section. I'll try to explain any of them in the easiest way I can. So that's all for this video. I hope you liked it. Please do subscribe to my channel if you have not already done, and keep watching. Thank you.